Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, retired senior lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity. My Christianity is of spirit, not of the letters. So I will tell you things which no book can tell. This Christianity is preached, and is preached face to face. And if you understand 50% what I say, you are a lucky person. 100 for definite or for thorough understanding, lectures face to face are important. So here it is. The woman said, I can see. It's not seeing, it's perceiving that you are a prophet. Prophets are perceived. They can, because in prophet what comes out of their mouth, that matters, and that you perceive the man is knowledgeable or not knowledgeable. Seeing is things of the flesh. That is, the woman was so spiritually advanced as to tell Jesus that he seems to be a prophet. That is why many Samaritan villages were not interested in Christ Jesus and did not bother if he did not come. But after the death of Jesus, Paul took many Samaritans to new spiritual heights. Our fathers in flesh worshipped their tribal gods called ILLAH on this mountain by spirit. But you Jews of letters claim that the place where we must worship is in Jerusalem, where no tribal gods were worshipped. This reference is to the worship of the statues of dead gods and goddesses called ILLAHs that were also placed around Kabah, the temple of Adam. You know the Kabah where the people go for a Hajj is a temple of Adam. And unless you are a son of man, you cannot be son of God. So that's why when they pray, Muhammadan pray, they face towards Kabah to honor Adam. But after the Hajj, they denounce him. That I will make it clear in another video. Village people honor them and dare not perform evil deeds. Thus, Samaritans, being the sons of man, unlike the Jews who were mostly sons of Satan, these Samaritans were salt of the earth, or of Adam. Moral teachers concentrated their moral teachings on respect and honor of their tribal elders, with spiritual preaching to the grown-ups, adults. This type of worship served its purpose when the moral teachers were men of spirit and their praises were with God and not with the men. Jesus declared, believe me, woman, a time, dark age of spirit, which is the present age, is coming when you will worship the Father God neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You Samaritan worship what you do not know, speaking in terms of the letters and not spirit. This is the sheer corruption in the Bible, as the Jewish people were so stiff-necked that they used to sit in the front circle of the temple, in the temple, and let Samaritans sit in the outer circle, despising them. We worship what we do know by the letters, for salvation is from the Jews. Seems to have been added on by the satanic Jewish people. Yet our bishop, which were mostly Jewish, yet the time is coming and has now come when the true worshippers will worship the living Father in spirit and truth, for they are the kind of worshippers the living Father seeks. God is spirit, abstract, is not something you can see. And his worshippers must worship in Holy Spirit, which is common sense, and in truth. The woman said, I know that Messiah is coming. This declaration of the Samaritan woman reflects a deep understanding of the religious knowledge by Holy Spirit that she and her people possessed. When he comes, he will explain everything to us. What a beautiful statement the woman made that reflected our deep religious knowledge, and indirectly we can say that she was sealed to serve God, and thus a highly religious person who was gifted with Holy Spirit, common sense. She knew what Christ stands for. In Christ Jesus, when we preach gospel, we do not open the books. We preach it from our heart, and we preach it on logical reasoning, making the things or building up the gospel from the very basic principles. We can explain many things which the books cannot explain, or it's not written in the books. So it is a brand new cloth which we present, but we need ears to hear it. Then Jesus declared, "I who speak to you am he." That is, Jesus was so pleased with her deep religious knowledge and spirit as to give out his identity with prayer, which he hid from the hylic and the psychic Pharisee Sadducees. Just then his laborers returned and were surprised to find him talking with a woman, but no one asked, "What do you want?" or "Why are you talking with her?" That is, Jesus and the woman, Samaritan woman, were locked in such a serious philosophical discussion that even his laborers dare not interpret it. Then, leaving her water jar for Jesus and his laborers to enjoy, the woman went back to the town and said to her people, "Come see a man who told me everything of my heart." That is, all her religious achievements. Could this be the Christ? She is in Jesus, or in God, we don't impose on anybody. Let them find themselves. So here it is, could this be the Christ? Let them find whether he is Christ or not. The pneumatics do not impose their own findings upon the others, but let them find it out by themselves through spirit. They came out of the town and made their way towards him. This gesture of welcoming Jesus amply reflects that the people of this town were very sensible people and did not wait for Christ Jesus, the fountain of living water, to go to them, but rather they went out towards him to greet and to welcome him into their humble village. In other towns, people did not come out to greet Jesus, and if they did so, it was mostly to get their sick people healed, while the people of Sychar did not come out to meet Jesus for the sick, but to honor a highly knowledgeable person, the anointed royal high priest of God, a prophet of this dark age, in the name of Christ Jesus. So I have put a home page under where I have displayed the Trinity, and that explain the five husband bit better position. So this is a very important portion, that how these people who are spiritual, they behave. In this village, people were so solitary in spirit that each one was allowed to test him or herself. Now, if the woman of this village was so spiritual, what about the men who must be very spiritual? So it was this whole village of this one that became saint, and they went out, spread into different part of the world, preaching gospel. And this Samaritan woman went to Carthage, and I have put a video on this woman. She was used to be called Saint Fortina. Fortina stands for light, and it's recently a Russian monastery have put out the true version of this woman. These English people, these German, and all these nonsense people have no idea of such things. They are people of book, and people of knowledge come from the East. And let's see that by the end of this word, we have the gospel preached. God bless you. Listen to my last part.